Hey everyone, and once again welcome to Google Ads Course. Myself Umar Taskeer. In this particular video, guys, we are basically going to talk about the remarketing settings or remarketing campus with regard to display networks for the display campus. So we are going to understand the concepts of remarketing with regards to display campus. How can we run remarketing campaigns by using display network or by using display campus or by using different creatives? So we have to consider some very important things, and as we also discussed earlier, that whenever we talk about remarketing campus or whenever we talk about the concepts of remarketing, one thing that we cannot ignore is basically the audience. So whenever we are saying that, okay, we want to run a remarketing campaign, it's all about the audience, it's all about that how we are going to create the audience, it's all about how we think about the audience in our mind, right? So what kind of audience creation you are basically adopting will define that what kind of remarketing campaign you will create, right? But another very important thing, see, whenever you are creating your audience for the purpose of remarketing, what you are basically doing is you are going to your website and identifying that, okay, if anyone is coming on this particular page, we want to create the audience of these visitors only. If anyone is coming on to this particular page, like contact page, we want to create an audience set of the visitors of this particular page, right? But think it like a way. For example, if you have like 10 pages on your website which are basically defining 10 different services of your website or 10 different services of your business. So if you have 10 different services which are there on your website and people visiting onto those pages are basically different kind of people. Why? Because see, when you are offering service number one, which is like for SEO, right? We can just assume this thing that there is like service number one on your website, which is for the SEO purpose. Then there is service number two on your website, which is for the Google Ads. So you have two different services, and those two different services are for basically two different audience set, right? So whenever you are basically going to remarket based on the visitors of your website, you have to identify that on which page the visitors actually visited, or on which page the visitors which are there on different pages, which page audience you want to use for the remarketing purpose. Because whenever you are using audience of SEO page, you have to create creatives, you have to create banners, you have to prepare content according to that particular audience so that you can cater that specific audience and you can capitalize on that. If you want to advertise or you want to remarket to the people who visited on your Google Ads, you should have content around Google Ads onto your banners, and then you should go for the remarketing campaign. So this is again a very important thing, that whenever we are going for the remarketing campaign, we have to think that what audience we are targeting to, and we have to create our banners, our remarketing campaigns, our creatives according to that particular audience only. That so you have to look at your creatives and try to figure out that, okay, are these creatives actually relevant to the audience to whom we are actually going to show these creatives? So you have to basically research around these things, right? So let's begin the process. And for this specific condition, the scenario that we are considering is like we want to show our display ad to the people who basically visited to a blog page but did not visited to contact page, right? So we are going to do something like this. It is very beneficial when you are having a website which is like e-commerce website. So you can definitely target product page, you can definitely target the add to cart page. You have different pages, right? Add to cart page, and then you have checkout page, and then you have payment done, and after that you will be redirected to this thank you page, right? So this is how it will work, right? So once you have your product page, right, and you have some visitors over here, right? So whenever you want to remarket to the people, like to the people who are basically visitors of product page but they did not convert it, right? So what you can do is you in your audience set, you can basically create an audience for like you want to create an audience who visited, or the people who visited on page of product, right? So you have to include this thing, product page will be included, and then you have to exclude the thank you page visits from there so that you will get the audience who actually visited to product page, add to cart page, or checkout page, but they did not visit it on the thank you page, which is like they haven't converted, right? So these are the different scenarios that we can create. So So for this specific video, we will consider a very basic example that people who visited blog page but did not visited service or contact page, whatever we can, right? So we can go to this audience section. It's very simple. We can go to this audience section, and then we have to create a new audience over here. Like this one, we have to create a new audience over here. We have to go to create new, we have to go to conditions, we have to select the page over here. So once we have selected the page, we will come down over here and we will write include this blog, right? So we have to include the blog URL over here like this one. So we have to now exclude. So we will add a filter over here and which will say exclude page contains. We'll come down, we will write page over here, we'll select page. Okay, let's see over here, right? So it's page and it will contain context, right? So we will copy the context from here. Very simple, we'll copy context and then we will apply this thing. Now we have to give it a name, right? So we will write blog visitors exclude, okay, context visitors. So it is up to you how you actually name them, because it is for you only. So we have to select the destinations now, and then we have to publish this thing, and we have to come back to our Google Ads account, and we have to see whether we can see this audience over here or not, and then we can go ahead and create a new display campaign with some good creatives that basically resonate with the audience that we have actually selected. So we have a new audience over here. Now we will go back to our Google Ads dashboard. We'll go back to campaign, we'll select new campaign, we'll go to without goals guidance, and then we'll select the display campaign over here. We will stick with this standard display campaign only, and then we will click on continue. Now we have to do some basic settings over here. We have to name this campaign like remarketing, and then you can write your audience name, whatever your audience name is, you can write that audience name over here. That will basically help you to determine which audience you are targeting. Then you can select the locations, languages, as we already discussed. Now you can select your bidding strategy from here. Okay, once you have selected your bidding strategy, you have to enter the budget as I am doing. Let's enter rupees 1000 for a day for now, just to understand. We have option of like ad rotation, ad scheduling over here, so we can do these things if we actually want. And then we have to select the audiences, right, which will be our remarketing audience. So we'll go to browse, we will go to remarketing, we'll go to website visitors, and over here we will select this thing, blog visitors, and excluding the contact visitors. So this is the audience, and then we will come down and we will basically see that how can we actually create our ad. So I'll recommend you to go with the uploaded display ad option, because these are customized, these are fully customized, and you can basically control what is there present on the image, right? So this is how you can create a remarketing display campaign, and further you can see the performance, and then you can optimize accordingly. So that's it for this specific video. I believe you got to know that how do we create audiences for the purpose of remarketing, and how can we use them into remarketing list search ads. Earlier we also discussed about things, and how can we use them into basically Google's display ad. So that's it. See you in the next video. Till then, goodbye.